Morning, it's Vicky Fraser here from Moxie Books, and today I wanted to talk about deliberate practice. This is my top book writing tip for you today. And it's really kind of topical because I'm recording this actually the day before, and I'm recording it at the end of a good 2 hours of me standing in front of the camera and going, because it seems a funny thing happens when I put my phone on a ring light holder. It seems that I forget to be able to make words with my face, and therefore what came out was mostly me just like swearing and looking to the ceiling and generally being a little bit woeful about the whole thing. So deliberate practice. What am I going on about? Okay, the reason I spent a couple of hours doing that and swearing and kind of having a little cry in the corner is because I'm not used to having this setup here, as you can probably tell. It's quite new to me. I'm not like a YouTuber. I don't do makeup tutorials. So if I want to get good at it, I'm going to have to practice. I've still got a very long way to go, but that's fine because I am doing deliberate practice. That's the thing, difference between practice and deliberate practice. Okay, I have been reading and learning from people about how to do these kinds of videos, believe it or not. So I'm trying to improve all the time. Just blindly practicing stuff, whether it's writing or anything else, isn't necessarily going to be very helpful. Because if you're practicing the wrong thing, all you're going to do is become better at doing it wrong, if that makes sense. And I'm going to give a big shout out to one of my besties, Yinka, for that, because she reminded us of that the other day on one of my power hours, moxiebooks.co.uk/power hour, if you want to join us. So deliberate practice. Make sure that you're doing whatever it is that you want to practice. Make sure you're doing it right and you're getting better all the time. And that goes for writing as well, because there's kind of this idea that anyone can write, because we're taught to do it in school, we're taught to do it from a really young age, so anyone can write, right? Wrong. Some people are very bad writers, some people are amazing writers, and then there's a lot of people who are somewhere in between. There's a lot of people who are okay, there's some people who are really good, some people are excellent, that kind of thing. You've got to practice the right thing, because writing is all about techniques as well. Just as if I was going to get on the trapeze and practice something, I want to make sure that I'm getting the right technique so that A, I'm not going to get injured, and B, it's efficient, and C, it's going to look beautiful. Same with writing, practice your techniques. How do you do that? Okay, I wondered for years how to do that. How do you do that? How do you practice? It's like you can take lessons, that kind of thing. Subscribe somewhere to some really good essay writing. The New Yorker is good for really good writing. There are other magazines and periodicals and things available. Subscribe to one that takes your fancy. Make sure it's just really well written though, and you'll be able to tell, because if you enjoy reading it, that's really good writing. And then read it a few times, make notes on it, make notes on what you like, what you didn't like, just make notes on it so that you can remember it, put it away, and then try and rewrite it in your own words. I'm not saying try and rewrite it word for word, but try and rewrite it as best you can from memory, and then compare it to the original. How does it do? Does it stand up? Are there bits that just are, you read it, it's like, oh, that's so much better than mine. Why is that better than mine? You can analyze it. So that is my top tip today, deliberate practice. Practice your writing, but do it deliberately. Hope that makes sense. If you've got any questions, you can join the Moxie Books Power Hour, moxiebooks.co.uk/power hour, and ask me anything. So that's the kind of thing we go into a lot more detail about after the writing session. So maybe I will see you there tomorrow morning. If not, have a beautiful day.